大家好，
我是 Stella，
我是 Warren， 今天要为您念的是练习手册
第84课，复习第67和68课。
第67课，爱把我创造的犹如他自身一样。 Lesson 67 Love created me like itself。
爱把我创造的犹如他自身一样。 Love created me like itself。 今天要复习的观念如下。 These are the ideas for today's review。 67，爱把我创造的犹如他自身一样。 Love created me like itself。我是按照物主的肖像而造的。 I am in the likeness of my creator。 我不可能受苦，也不可能失落，更不可能死亡。 I cannot suffer。 I cannot experience loss and I cannot die。 我不是一具身体。 I am not a body。 我今天愿认清自己的实相。 I would recognize my reality today。 我不愿供奉任何偶像，也不再抬出自我观念来取代我的真实自信。 I will worship no idols nor raise my own self-conceptTo replace myself。 我是按造物主的肖像而造的。 I am in the likeness of my creator。 爱已将我创造的犹如他自身一样。 Love created me like itself。 下列的格式有助于你发挥今天的观念。 You might find these specific forms helpful in applying the idea。不要让我在此世上看到自我的幻象。 Let me not see an illusion of myself in this。 愿我在此世上忆起自己的造物主。 As I look on this, let me remember my creator。 我眼前所见的模样绝不是造物主的创造。 My creator did not create this as I see it。
第68课，爱内没有怨尤。 Lesson 68 Love holds no grievances。
爱内没有怨尤。 Love holds no grievances。 爱内没有怨尤。 Love holds no grievances。68，爱内没有怨尤。 Love holds no grievances。 爱是完全不懂得怨尤的。 Grievances are completely alien to love。 怨尤打击了爱，遮蔽了它的光明。 Grievances attack love and keep it light obscure。 只要我还心怀怨尤，我就是在攻击爱，也等于打击了我的自信。 If I hold grievances, I am attacking love, and therefore attacking myself。 自信充斥成了我的末路。 Myself thus becomes alien to me。 我下定决心今天不再打击我的自信，如此我才可能忆起自己的真实面目。I am determined not to attack myself today so that I can remember who I am。 下面几个具体的应用格式对你会很有帮助。 These specific forms for applying this idea would be helpful。 这一件事并不足以否定我的自信。 This is no justification for denying myself。 我不愿借此事而打击爱。 I will not use this to attack love。 愿我不受此事的蒙蔽而伤害自己。 Let this not tempt me to attack myself。 以下是 J 兄的示意。 You are blessed beings indeed。你确实是有福之人。 I am that one that you know as Jesus, and it is important for you to really deeply
contemplate these lessons today. Love holds no grievances.
我是你所知的 JC， 今天你务必确实的深思这课的内容，爱内没有怨尤。
And that means that as a being made of love, from love,For love, holding grievances is you using your free will to hide the truth of who you are from yourself. And so you will suffer because you are disconnected from the truth, which is that you are a loving being.
这意味着你的本质是爱，你是由爱所照，且是为了爱而受照。你一旦心怀怨尤，表示你用你的自由意志来掩盖自己的真正本质。你会因此而受苦，因为你断绝了你是充满爱的生命的这个真相。
This is a simple practice. Saying words like this do not seem to have great import. When you are trained in your society, you are not taughtThat saying words to yourself changes anything.
这是一个简单的练习，但你会认为说这类的话看似没有太大的作用，因为当你在社会中接受教育时，你并没有学过对自己说一些话能改变事情的观念。
It's an objective world. They say to you, you thinking?Something different or saying something different is not going to make any difference out there.
相反的，你学到的观念是这是一个客观的世界，你用不同的方式来说或是说些不同的话并不会对外在世界产生任何影响。
The out there is solid. It is a hard copy. But what we tell you isIt is a printout from the software that you are all running in your heads.
外在世界是坚固的实体，它犹如列印出来的文件。但是我们要告诉你的是，这个列印文件是出自你脑中运作的软件。
You understand similarly. It is like malware installed.In your computer, and the printout becomes distorted, and the words are not formed properly.
你了解这个比喻，就好比你的电脑里安装了恶意软件，它使得列印出来的内容受到扭曲，文字无法正确的显示。
This is what's happening in your world. The malware that you have had installedIn your head, that you are ugly, or that you are going to die, that God is vengeful and hates you and will punish you. He even punished his most beloved son in a most horrendous way. Even though that person was so good, what is going to happen to you?
这就是你的世界之情况。你安装在头脑中的恶意软件，例如你很丑陋，你必死无疑，上主是会报复的，他会厌恶你或惩罚你，他甚至用最可怕的方式来惩罚他挚爱的儿子，就算那个人是那么善良，可以想见你将会遭受什么情况。
These are the malware stories that you have had downloaded into your hard drive, so to speak, and saying these words repeatedly throughout the day, practicing them, honoring them, eventually integrating them and believing them is you cleaning up the hard drive of your computer so that theprintout will be clear and clean, comprehensible.
这些都是
恶意软件中的故事，而你将它下载到你的硬碟中。因此，请在这一整天当中反复对自己说课程中的这些话语，练习这些观念，遵从这些观念，最终接纳这些观念，相信这些观念。这样做是在清理你的电脑之硬碟。如此一来，列印出来的文件将会是清晰的、干净的，且是你能看得懂的。 That is what we are seeking here. We are seeking to clean up that which does not belong in your most sacred mind. 这便是我们在时常试着的事。我们试图清理那些不属于你最神圣的心灵之观念。 And so when you get a grievance,When you feel resentment today, when you get angry at someone, quickly observe what has happened.
所以当你心怀怨尤时，当你今日感到怨恨时，当你生某人的气时，请快速地观察自己究竟是怎么回事。
You have unplugged from love for a moment and you feel awful, but you want to plug back into love so that you feel good. And so, you let it go.
你一时切断了爱的连接，这时你感觉很糟，但是你想要重新连接上爱，使你能感觉到美好，因此你放下怨尤。
As beginner students of A Course in Miracles, you are going to get triggered, you are going to get emotional, you are going to get upset because you have so many contaminating ideas in the mind.
身为刚入门的奇迹学员，你会被激怒，你会情绪化，你会感到烦恼，因为你心中有太多制造污染的观念。
But what you can do is bring this teaching as the remedy. What you can do is instead of getting into a big, long, drawn-out argument,With someone, you can say.
但你能做的是，以这个教诲作为你的治疗方法。你能做的是，不要与人陷入没完没了的争论。你可以说
，This is not going to serve either of us to fight. I choose love. I love you.
争吵对我们彼此都没有帮助。我选择爱，我爱你。
And you will be surprised.At some of the things that will happen, some people will refuse your love. Some people will stand up and give you a hug.
你会惊讶于接下来将发生的事。有些人会拒绝你的爱，有些人会站起来给你一个拥抱。
But you will begin to see that you are not wasting your energy and your time on things that you do not like.And that you don't want to participate in anymore.
但是你会开始看到，你没有浪费你的能量和时间在你不喜欢且及你不想再参与的事情上。
This book is true medicine. It will bring you peace, and you will see that it is a scientific process.
这部课程是真正的解药，它会带给你平安。你会明白这是符合科学精神的处理方式。
Cleaning up the hardware, removing the malware from your programs will make the printout much more comprehensible.
清理硬碟，清除程式中的恶意软件，这会使你列印出来的文件更加清楚明了。
I am that one that you know as Jesus, and we will see you again tomorrow.
我是你所知的 JC, 我们明天再会。
让我们再来唱一次吧。
爱把我创造的犹如他之身一样 Love created me like itself 爱内没有缘由 Love holds no grievances 爱内没有缘由 Love holds no grievances
第84课复习第67和68课。
第67课，爱把我创造的犹如他自身一样。Lesson 67. Love created me like itself. Lesson 68. Love holds no grievances. 奇迹之吻第八章回归之道。Chapter 8. The journey back. 第九节疗愈即是修正的之见。 9.Healing has corrected perception.
第五段开始，疗愈能消除人对警觉的恐惧，并且以觉醒的决心取而代之。 Healing is released from the fear of waking and the substitution of the decision to wake. 觉醒的决心反映出爱的愿力，因为任何疗愈说穿了就是以爱取代恐惧的过程。 The decision to wake is the reflection of the will to love, since all healing involves replacing fear with love. 圣灵不可能帮你区分错误的大小轻重，如果他告诉你这病比那病更严重，这无异于说某种错误比另一错误更真实。 The Holy Spirit cannot distinguish among degrees of error, for if he taught that one form of sickness is more serious than another, he would be teaching that one error can be more real than another. 他的唯一任务就是教你分辨真假虚实，如何以真实取代虚假之物。His function is to distinguish only between the false and the true, replacing the false with the true. 小我想尽办法削弱心灵的力量，他故意把身心分开，目的是要毁灭心灵。 The ego, which always wants to weaken the mind, tries to separate it from the body.In an attempt to destroy it. 而小我却认定自己是在保护心灵。 Yet the ego actually believes that it's protecting it. 由于小我相信心灵是极其危险的东西，唯有把它变为飞行之物才有疗愈的可能。 That is because the ego believes that mind is dangerous and that to make mindless to heal. 但心灵是不可能变成飞星的，否则表示它能把上主的召唤变成虚无。 But to make mindless to impossible, since it would mean to make nothing out of what God created. 小我轻视软弱无能，却不断削弱你的力量。 The ego despises weakness, even though it makes every effort to induce it. 小我追求的总是自己憎恨之物。The ego wants only what it hates. 对小我而言，这是情非得已。To the ego, this is perfectly sensible. 小我如此相信攻击的力量，它不会不发动攻击的。Believing in the power of attack, the ego wants attack. 圣经劝你活得完美神圣，疗愈所有的错误，无视身体为分裂的个体，因我之名而完成所有的任务。 The Bible enjoins you to be perfect, to heal all errors, to take no thought of the body as separate, and to accomplish all things in my name.不只因我之名，也因我们之名，只因我们的身份全然相同。 This is not my name alone, for ours is a shared identification. 上主之子只有一个圣名，他劝你去做爱的事工，因为我们共享上主的一体生命。The name of God's Son is one, and you are enjoyedTo do the works of love because we share this oneness. 我们的心灵完整无缺，因为它们属于同一生命。Our minds are whole because they are one. 你若生病，表示你在逃避我。 If you are sick, you are withdrawing from me. 然而你不可能只回避我一人的。Yet you cannot withdraw from me alone. 你回避我之际同时回避了你自己。You can only withdraw from yourself and me. 你一定逐渐意识到这课程的实用性，如此铁口直断，毫不含糊。You have surely begun to realize that this is a practical course and one that means exactly what it says. 我不可能要求你去做你办不到的事，凡是我能做到的，你不可能做不到。I would not ask you to do things you cannot do, and it is impossible that I could do things you cannot do.基于此，没有任何事情阻挡得了我要求你做的事，而且宇宙万物都在为你伸冤。我这话可是千真万确。Given this and given this quite literally, nothing can prevent you from doing exactly what I ask, and everything argues for you doing it.
我不会加给你任何限制的，因为上主从未限制过你。
I give you no limits because God lays none upon you.
当你画地直线时，我们就不再同心一意了，那就是疾病之始。
When you limit yourself, we are not of one mind, and that is sickness.
疾病不是身体的问题，而是心灵的问题。
Yet sickness is not of the body, but of the mind.
所有的疾病都是心灵分裂的征兆，表示他已拒绝了那个一贯目标。
All forms of sickness are signs that the mind is split and does not accept a unified purpose.
圣灵唯一的疗愈之方即是帮你重新把目标统一起来。
The unification of purpose, then, is the Holy Spirit's only way of healing.
因为唯有那一层次的疗愈才有意义。
This is because it is the only level at which healing means anything.
在混乱无序的思想体系中，唯有重新赋予它某种意义，才可能产生疗愈。
The re-establishing of meaning in a chaotic thought system is the way to heal it.
你的职责只是背妥意义所需的先决条件，因为意义是属于上主之境。
Your task is only to meet the conditions for meaning, since meaning itself is of God.
然而，唯有等到你重新活出意义，上主的意义才会圆满，因为你的意义是他意义的一部分。
Yet, your return to meaning is essential to his, because your meaning is part of his.
因此，你的疗愈成了他健康的因素，因为你的疗愈属于他圆满生命的一部分。
Your healing, then, is part of his health, since it is part of his wholeness.
他不可能失去圆满性，但你却可能对这圆满生命一无所知。
He cannot lose this, but you cannot know it.
上主的旨意依旧愿你活得圆满，而他的旨意必然永存于万物之中。
Yet it is still his will for you, and his will must stand forever and in all things.
奇迹之吻第八章回归之道 Chapter 8 The Journey Back 第九节疗愈即是修正的之见 9. Healing as corrected perception 愿大家有一个圣灵充满的一天阿们我爱你哟、哦